In this video, I will be discussing multiple choice questions of class 10th physics chapter number 6 equilibrium. First MCQ. Torque about an axis is defined as the product of, as we know students, torque is denoted by tau and it is the product of force and moment R. Torque is a vector quantity. Body will rotate, turn either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise torque is taken as positive torque. And clockwise torque is taken as negative torque. These are the two types of torque. Here we have torque about an axis is defined as the product of force and moment R. C option. Torque is a vector quantity and its unit is Newton meter. Force is in Newton and moment R is in meter. So in next MCQ, the SI unit of torque is torque ka unit Newton meter hai. Torque is equal to F into P. Force in Newton, moment R in meter, Newton meter. Torque is a dash quantity. As we know, torque is a vector quantity. If body will move in clockwise direction, torque will be negative. If body will move in anti-clockwise direction, torque will be positive. MCQ number 4. If two parallel forces have same direction, they are called like parallel forces. If they have opposite direction, then they are called unlike parallel forces. Opposite direction mein unlike parallel forces hoti hai aur same direction mein like parallel forces hoti hai. MCQ number 5. A body is said to be in equilibrium if it is moving with. We know students ki equilibrium ek state hai. If body is in a state of rest or moving with uniform velocity, then it's said to be in a state of equilibrium, means zero acceleration. In equilibrium, body has zero acceleration, uniform velocity. Same velocity means zero acceleration. Average acceleration, body is moving with acceleration, no. Variable velocity, no. Uniform velocity. A body is said to be in equilibrium if it is moving with uniform velocity. Or uniform velocity ki case mein dynamic equilibrium hota hai. Or rest ke case mein static equilibrium hota hai. Static equilibrium. We have two types of equilibrium. If body is in a state of rest, static. If body is in a state of uniform motion, then dynamic equilibrium. MCQ number 6. A body is moving with uniform velocity. It is said to be stable equilibrium, neutral equilibrium. Is stable or unstable or neutral. Ye tino states of equilibrium hai. Jabki hume discuss kya karna hai? A body is moving with uniform velocity. It is said to be dynamic equilibrium. If body is in a state of rest, that is said to be static equilibrium. Rest mein static equilibrium hota hai. First condition of equilibrium is sum of all forces is equal to zero. First condition mein hum kya dekhte hain? Sum of all forces. Aur second condition mein kya dekhte hain? Sum of all torque. Second condition of equilibrium, sum of all torque producing in a body is equal to zero. That is said to be the state of equilibrium. This is the second condition of equilibrium. और स्टूडेंट्स नॉलेज के लिए बता रहा हूं कि फर्स्ट कंडीशन जब भी सेटिस्फाई होती है तो बॉडी ट्रांसलेशनल इक्विलिब्रियम में होती है. ट्रांसलेशनल इक्विलिब्रियम इफ फर्स्ट कंडीशन सेटिस्फाइड देन द बॉडी सेट टू बी इन ट्रांसलेशनल इक्विलिब्रियम. इफ सेकंड कंडीशन सेटिस्फाइज द बॉडी सेट टू बी रोटेशनल इक्विलिब्रियम. Point number MCQ number 8, the point at which the whole weight of the body appears to act is called center of gravity. Let's suppose we have sphere, we have ball, football. The center of gravity of the spherical body is at its center. This is the center of gravity. Whole weight of the body will act at the center of the sphere. The point at which whole weight of the body appears is called center of gravity. MCQ number 9, a body will be in a state of stable equilibrium if its center of gravity lies. So we have three states of equilibrium. States of equilibrium. One is stable. Second is unstable. Third is neutral. If body is in stable equilibrium, then center of gravity lies below. If body is in unstable equilibrium, then center of gravity lies above. If body is in neutral equilibrium, then center of gravity lies at the point of suspension or support. ये बहुत मिलते जुलते MCQ है, इसमें अक्सर मिस्टेक हो जाती है. तो MCQ number 9 था, a body will be in stable equilibrium. Stable का पूछ रहा है, if its center of gravity lies, center of gravity की location पूछी जा रही है. तो stable में below the point of suspension, at the point of suspension क्या होता है? neutral. Above the point of suspension क्या होता है? unstable. Number 10, if the center of gravity of a body is lower, center of gravity lies lower, below, then its point of support, then its equilibrium will be, to below ke case mein kya hoga? Stable equilibrium. Kya maine abhi upar baat batai? Ke below mein kya hota hai? Stable. अबव में क्या होता है? अनस्टेबल. और न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम में सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी लाइज एट द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन. नंबर 11, अ बॉडी इज सेट टू बी इन स्टेट ऑफ न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम इफ इट्स सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी लाइज एट द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन. Number 12, an acrobat walking on a rope is an example of acrobat, ek wire par, ek string par, ek बंदा वॉक कर रहा है, a man is walking on a roof is called acrobat. Acrobat walking on a roof is an example of unstable equilibrium. क्यों भाई? क्योंकि अगर ये disbalance होगा तो ये उस wire से गिर जाएगा. ऐसे ही अगर आप pencil को vertically इसकी टिप पर स्टैंड करोगे तो ये पेंसिल गिर जाएगी. पेंसिल स्टैंडिंग ऑन इट्स एपेक्स, या फिर अ कोन स्टैंडिंग ऑन इट्स एपेक्स. तो ये अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम होता है. स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम में क्या होगा? लेट सपोज अ कार स्टैंडिंग एट इट्स इन पार्किंग. एक कार है फ्लोर पर, या एक बुक रखी हुई है फ्लोर पर, एक चेयर है, तो स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम की एग्जांपल्स है. न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम की क्या एग्जांपल्स थी? कि एक फुटबॉल बॉल फ्लोर पर मौजूद है, या अगर हम एक कोन को इसकी साइड पर लाई करें, या फिर एक पेंसिल इस तरह से फ्लोर पर रखी हो, तो ये न्यूट्रल इक्विलिब्रियम होता है. अच्छे से अब बेटा आपको इनकी एग्जांपल्स क्लियर होनी चाहिए एग्जाम में एमसीक्यू पूछा जाता है. नंबर 13, अ कोन स्टैंडिंग ऑन इट्स बेस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. कोन स्टैंडिंग ऑन इट्स बेस, ये कोन है और कोन इसकी बेस पर स्टैंड कर रही है, स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम होगा.